The 570 has always been a real fantasy bike of mine, so I've just put together a very poorly edited video to share some of the experiences I had last September in Beechworth on the 570 and the FX450.
What a car! Five minutes into our ride, his fucking bike bloke's up. Can't maintain his shit. Fucking bird.
So riding the 570 was a pretty interesting experience. It was really, the best way to describe it was, it was the most aggressive dual sport I've ever ridden. Recently, riding one of the newer 500s and having the 2007 550, the best way to describe it would be it's smack bang in the middle of those bikes. It's the most perfect do everything bike, and the footage that I'm using in this video is all single track because it just ate it up. It was the only time that I could actually keep up to Alan on his 450, and even then most of the time he was right out in front. He barely shows up in any of the videos because for an old bastard he can ride. So after riding the newer KTM 500, which is essentially the same as the 13 and 14 501 Berg, I thought to myself, well, the 570 really has a lot to live up to now after riding this bike. It was an incredible enduro weapon, absolute machine. And the 550, well, it's still the funnest bike I've ever ridden, hands down. So the 570 lived up to my expectations. It felt very natural to me. It's definitely not as eccentric as the older Bergs. It's more of a missing link between the old carby bikes and the newer fuel-injected machines of today. It is a large bike compared to the 500s of today, so it does have its limitations, but at the same time it's the most perfect light adventure bike I think that's on the market still. I mean, you've got the 690 and 701 obviously, but they're a lot of money and you can pick these 570s up for, you know, 4, 5, 6 grand, so I think they're almost at the stage where they are a classic, they are getting older. Would I have one? Absolutely, in a heartbeat, if it was within my means. I'll put together another video with some footage with a 450 in it as well, and do a bit of a comparison, because you would think that 450 and 570, there wouldn't be that much difference, bar the top end, the 570 having a bit more go in the top, but it was almost like riding completely different bikes. So I'm going to turn up the motorbike sounds on the video now and stop talking. That's if you've been that bored that you've actually listened this far into it. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I will make some more incredibly poorly edited videos in the near future. Cheers.
Fuck up. the temps are on that radiator cap.